Hi, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss an important topic of class 10, quadratic equations. Quadratic equation is very important because we will get all variety of questions from this. Very short answer, long answers, all questions can be asked from this chapter. And this is very important chapter. The concept of this chapter we will use in the higher classes also, solving a quadratic equation. Quadratic, quadra means two. So a linear equation of the form ax plus b, it is called a linear equation, degree 1. Ax square plus bx plus c is called a quadratic equation of second degree. Power 2 is there. So it is called a second degree expression. Ax square plus bx plus c is always called a quadratic expression. If it is equated to 0, then it is called equation. So expression and equation. An expression equated to something need not be zero. Expression equated to something is called an equation because equality symbol is there, otherwise it is called an expression. So it is a second degree polynomial in x. X is a variable, not always x, you can have any variable. Ay square plus by plus c equal to 0 is a quadratic equation in terms of y. So this is a second degree expression which is equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. Every quadratic equation will have at most two zeros of the polynomial or two roots of the equation. We have seen in polynomial chapter of class 10. A polynomial, wherever it meets an x-axis, they are all zeros of the polynomial. So if a quadratic equation drawn like this, if roots exist, it will be like this or like this. So these are the roots of the expression or the roots of the equation. So quadratic equation will have at most two zeros of the polynomial. And in polynomials, we have learned about this concept, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, whose zeros are alpha and beta. If alpha and beta are the zeros, then alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Alpha into beta is c by a. These formula already we learned in the chapter polynomials. So every quadratic equation will have at most two zeros. If alpha beta are the zeros, then alpha plus beta, alpha into beta. A is called coefficient of x square, b is called coefficient of x, and c is the constant term of the quadratic equation. Now x square, if x square exists, then only it is called a quadratic. If x square term is not present, then it is not a quadratic. Look at this. X cube plus 4x plus 7. Let me take x square also. It is not a quadratic because highest power of x is 3. So it is called cubic equation. X power 4, 7x cube plus 6x square plus 6 equal to 0. Something like this. Power 4, it is called a biquadratic equation. So if x square term exists and if x square is the highest power of x, then only it is called a quadratic, otherwise it is not a quadratic. In our first exercise 4.1, there are some quadratic equations. You have to identify which is quadratic or not. There will be some expressions like this. For example, x plus 1 into x minus 1 is x square plus 3x plus 2. Is it a quadratic? By looking at the equation given, x square is available, so generally we feel that it is a quadratic equation. But wait, let us complete this. X plus 1, x minus 1, a plus b into a minus b form. So x square plus 3x plus 2, x square gets cancelled, 3x plus 3 equal to 0. X square is not available, so it is not a quadratic equation. It is not a quadratic equation, it is a linear equation. So like this, we have many questions in the first exercise where you have to identify whether it is a quadratic or not. Is it a quadratic? One more question of what has to do. X square plus 3x plus 1 equal to x square plus 4 minus 4x. X square gone. When x square term absent, then we can say yes, it is not a quadratic equation. If x square term exists, then only it is a quadratic. X square term exists and it should be the highest power of x, then only. If you have more than x square, like x cube, x power 4, it is not a quadratic equation. So in the first exercise,
I have done only one or two questions. We have to identify whether the given equation is a quadratic or not, and we have to frame some quadratics.
For example, sum of two numbers is 10 and the product of numbers is 25.
Frame a quadratic. Sum of two numbers, let xy be the numbers, sum of two numbers is 10 and product of the numbers is 25,
x into this y. Quadratic should be a single variable expression or equation. So I have to remove y. From this y I can write as 10 minus 6. So if I multiply 10x minus x square is 24, they goes to that side, x square minus 10x plus 24 equal to 0.
This is called a quadratic equation. So we must be able to frame a quadratic equation also. In the first exercise, identification of quadratic equation and framing a quadratic equation based on the given hints. You will be given always two hints. Two hints will be there. So let number be x and y and use the hints and get into a single variable function either in terms of x or in terms of y.
So we know that a second degree polynomial will have maximum two zeros of the polynomial. Zeros of the polynomial are called the roots of the quadratic equation.
Now in the next exercise 4.2, we discuss about a quadratic equation and we will try to solve a quadratic equation using factors method.
In our syllabus, there are three methods we are going to study. One is factorization. Factorization is not a new topic already in 7th and 8th.
We have discussed about this midterm factorization.
Then, completing square method. Then, formula.
So, three methods are there in our syllabus to solve a quadratic equation. So, what are those methods and how to do this?
Whenever a quadratic equation is given, if you want to do this by factorization, x square plus bx plus c equal to 0, let us solve this by factorization. First of all, what you have to do is, you have to multiply a into c, you will get a product ac. Then try to get the factors of ac. So first multiply a into c, try to get the factors of ac. Factors of ac such that the product should give ac and the addition should give the number b. Simple example, x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. Solve the quadratic equation x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. How to solve this? Coefficient of x square 1, constant term is 6, 1 into 6 is 6. Try to find the factors of 6, 3 into 2, 6 into 1, what we know generally. 3 plus 2, 5, but we need minus 5. 6 plus 1, 7, but we need minus 5. So total minus 5 is needed and the product should be 6. 3 plus 2 is giving 5 but not minus 5. So what I will do is I will take both minus and minus. With this what happens? Minus 3 into minus 2. The product 6 retains 8 and the addition becomes minus 5. So we write this 5x in terms of 3 and 2. That means 3x, 2x plus 6 equal to 0. X common, x minus 3. Take maximum available always common. Here minus 2 can be taken. You can take 2 also, but that won't solve the purpose. Here x minus 3 is there. The same term you have to take. Further I am taking minus 2. When minus 2 is taken common, x minus 2 means minus 3 equal to 0. Now x minus 3 common, we left with x and minus 2 equal to 0. So x will be 3 and x will be 2, or the zeros of the polynomial or the roots of a quadratic equation. This is called midterm factorization. When number is small, then easily you can find the factors. If number is big, it is a 3-digit number, more than 100, then for all the students it is not easy. Some students who are good at the multiplication, factorization, they may get the solution. If you are feeling any difficulty finding the factors, then we go for other methods, completing square or the formula. Formula is the best method, ultimate. All problems can be done using formula, whether roots, whether factors easily exist or not. In this method would be easy. So this is factorization method. You have to find the product, x square coefficient and the constant. Find the factors, suitable factors, so that the total gives the coefficient of x. Let me do one more problem on factorization. Coefficient of x square and constant 12 minus 4 into minus 3. 4 into 3, but I need minus 7. So I have taken minus 4 minus 3. You have to see that the sum should be always the coefficient of x and product is this. Now 2x square minus 4x minus 3x plus 6 equal to 0. Try to take maximum available common. I have taken 2x, so x will be there, and minus 2. I have taken minus 3 common, so x minus 2. So x minus 2, 2x minus 3 equal to 0. So for this, x equal to 2 and 2x minus 3 means x equal to 3 by 2. These are the zeros of the polynomial. They are the roots of the quadratic equation. So this is how I am getting the solution of this quadratic equation. So factorization is very easy. This is a basic method. If you know the factorization, product of numbers, multiplication, all this, then easily you can get. But always it is not so easy. When we are dealing with big numbers, it may take time. But factorization will help you to find the factors. In examination, generally methods will not be mentioned to you. They won't give any specific method except the completing square. If option is given to you, you can follow any method whichever you feel comfortable or easy. If it is difficult, you can go always for the formula. If they insist you to do the factorization method, then only do the factorization. Otherwise, you can choose any method. Feel free to choose the method. Generally, completing square will be the question. They insist to do it by completing square. Let us do one more question. CBSC festival. Sum of two numbers is 27 and the product of the numbers is 182. Sum of two numbers, third question of 4.2, if I remember. Sum of two numbers is 27, product of the numbers is 182, then find the numbers. Let the numbers be the same model I have explained in the explanation, in the introduction. Let the numbers be x and y. X plus y is 27. X into y is 182. Y has to be removed from this. Y is 27 minus x is 182. So 27x minus x square is 182. X square 27x plus 182 equal to 0. So factorization 1 into 182. So 182 is the product. What are the factors of 182? So that it should be minus 27. It is a positive number. So both should be positive or both should be negative. But to have minus, I need both minus. Minus 14 and minus 13. How I got minus 14 and minus 13? You have to check. 182. Let us take 2 into 91. 291 total is not 27. So it is not with the 2. Then go for 3, then 4. Like this, you have to see where you can get the factors. Or complete factor is 182 and group the numbers. So x minus 14 and x minus 13 equal to 0. So the numbers are x 13 or x 14. When x is 13, y will be 14. When x is 14, y will be 13. So two numbers, 13, 14 or 14, 13 makes no difference. Now after factorization, very important and tricky, completing square method. When factorization is difficult for you, then you can go for a completing square method. Generally they will insist this method if this question is asked. If they give solve the quadratic by completing square method, then you have to do only by completing square. So x square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. How to find the roots of x by completing square method? I have taken a general equation. To get the roots of a quadratic equation by completing square method, you have to follow three important steps. One is make coefficient of x square as 1. Coefficient of x square should be made 1. Coefficient of x square must be made 1. Coefficient of x should be a 2 multiple. coefficient of x must be a 2 multiple. This 2 multiple, 2 and x multiple. So 2x multiple, whatever this multiple is there, add square, subtract square has to be done.
Add square, subtract square has to be done.
Remember these three important steps, then easily you can solve a quadratic equation. So let me explain this with an example. 2x square minus 7x plus 3 equal to 0. Just now we did this in factorization. Let me do this by completing square. Coefficient of x square must be 1. So take 2 common. X square minus 7 by 2x plus 3 by 2 equal to 0. It becomes x square minus 7 by 2x plus 3 by 2 equal to 0. 2 goes that side. First step is satisfied. First step is done. Coefficient of x must be 2. 7 is not an even number, it is not multiple of 2. So I am multiplying and dividing with 2. Multiplying and dividing with 2. Plus 3 by 2 square. This 3 by 2, not square. This 3 by 2 you can set to that side. X square minus 2 into 7 by 4x. Now 7 by 4 and subtract. Or add on both the sides. That also can be done. So coefficient of x must be made 2 into something. So 2x, whatever 7 by 4, add on both the sides. Add on both the sides. A square, b square, 2ab form. So I am getting a complete square, a minus b whole square minus 3 by 2 plus 7 square, 49 by 16. So what happens? X minus 7 by 4 whole square equal to 16 is the LCM, 2, 8, 8, 3 is 24. So minus 24 plus 49 by 16, which is 25 by 16. X minus 7 by 4 is root 25 by 16. X minus 7 by 4 plus or minus 5 by 4. So x minus 7 by 4 is 5 by 4. X minus 7 by 4 is minus 5 by 4. That goes to that side. Plus 7 by 4, 7 plus 5, 12 by 4, 3, and that goes to that side. Plus 7 by 4, 7 minus 5 is 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. So this is the completing square method. Just a little tricky, but if you remember these three points, easily we can go for a completing square method. Make x square coefficient always 1, always 1, then easy to get the result. Then x multiple should be a 2 multiple. So 2 into something is compulsory. So 2 into something. Whatever the something, 2 into number, that number square you have to add on both the sides. Add subtract goes that side, otherwise adding on both the sides. This will become a minus b whole square and the remaining is the result. So x minus 7 by 4 whole square is minus 3 by 2 plus 49 by 16. That simplification will do 25 by 16 and some number. Finally you will get the value 6 equal to 3 and x equal to 1 by 2. So these are the results. This is how we do by completing square method. I think this is clear. Please look at the method carefully. Repeat the video many number of times so that you will get some clarity on this. Now the final formula. Let me apply completing square method to this. Then we get the formula. Formula is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is the formula. Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a is the formula. This formula we are using to solve a quadratic equation whenever quadratic is this form. How the formula is obtained, though the proof is immaterial, but let me give the proof so that I can repeat completing square method. If this is done by completing square method, a is common, x square plus b by x plus c by a equal to 0. I need 2 multiple, so into 2 by 2, this c by a goes to that side, minus c by a, x square 2 into v by 2ax, v by 2a, add on both the sides, v by 2a whole square, this become x plus v by 2a whole square, this is minus c by a, b square by 4a square, x plus b by 2a whole square is 4a square LCM minus 4ac, 1a is already there, so only 4a goes to that side. So x plus b by 2a will be plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 4a, you can write as 4a square and as 2a whole square. So x goes to that side, minus b by 2a plus or minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. 2a is the LCM that gives this. So this is the formula, this is a proof how we got the formula. Minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a, the formula what we are using, how we got this, this is a proof. Using completing square method steps, got the result. Let me take the same problem, solve the quadratic using formula. In the beginning stage when you are learning this, don't be in hurry, write the quadratic, compare terms A, B, C, then find B square minus 4AC first, B square minus 4AC, 49 minus 24, that is 25. So I am getting a positive value because b square minus 4ac is under root. If it is a negative value, then I can't proceed. So there are some conditions on b square minus 4, I will explain after this question. Now write the formula, minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So minus b, 7 plus or minus b square minus 4ac is 25, 2 into a is 2. So it become 7 plus or minus 5 by 4. So 7 plus 5, 1 by 4, 7 minus 4. So 3 and 1 by 2, they are the roots of the quadratic equation. This is how we get using formula. So you have to write the given quadratic and compare to the standard quadratic, list out ABC values. While taking, you have to consider the sign also. Many people will take B as 7 and then let minus sign. No, coefficient of x is including sign you have to take. So everything you have to take step by step and you have to solve the quadratic equation. This is how we do using formula. Here no need to worry about the factors exist or not. The root value, if perfect root and the root, then get the root value. If it is not a perfect square, then you can keep root as it is, plus or minus root, two values will get always a quadratic. Here b square minus 4ac is denoted by d. This is called the discriminant of the quadratic equation. B square minus 4ac is called the discriminant of a quadratic equation. If this is equal to 0, under root everything is going to become 0. So plus or minus 0 has no effect. You will get two roots which are equal to each other. So if B square minus 4ac is 0, we will get equal roots. So discriminant 0, we will get equal roots. D, that is b square minus 4ac is 0, so we will get equal roots. If D, b square minus 4ac becomes negative, if it becomes negative, under root negative values you are getting, under root negative values means no real roots, they are imaginary roots. Root, negative value under root is not a real number, so no real roots. If b square minus 4ac greater than 0, means I am getting a positive value under root, positive value under root exist in real numbers. Perfect square, perfect number, otherwise, so for example, root 7, it will be root 7 only, irrational number also part of the real numbers. So b square minus 4ac greater than 0, then real roots, since it is not equal to 0, we will get two separate roots, two distinct roots. So nature of roots. Not only solving a quadratic, problems can be expected on nature of roots also.
If b square minus 4 is equal to 0, both the roots are equal, you can expect questions on this addition will be given a quadratic. Suppose they will give a quadratic, x square plus 3x plus k equal to 0. This has two roots equal, then what is the value of k? So you have to make b square minus 4 ac of this equal to 0, then get the value of k. So these model questions you can expect. All variety of questions will be discussed in the next video. In this video, I am giving the introduction of the quadratic equation, what we study in this chapter. Problems, word problems and problems on nature of roots, all will be discussed in the next video which will be released after this video. So when b square minus 4 is equal to 0, equal roots, if it is negative, no real roots, because under root negative is not a real number. If it is greater than 0, then we will get both the roots, real roots and different distinct roots we are going to get. So this is the information about quadratic equations. So in this video, I have tried to explain the concept of quadratic equation. If you are ready with the concept, that means you are ready with the weapon and you can go for the fight. So all the concepts are cleared in this video. Go through the video repeatedly to get the clear concept on the formula, proofs, everything. So read it repeatedly, you will get clear idea. Now all different problems, word problems, all will be discussed in the next video which will be released after this video. So as a request, every time I repeat once again, please subscribe the channel and try to share maximum so that it will be helpful to the students. Okay, have a good day.